Hello and welcome back. Today's video is an update for Finish 5 by Fall Project Pan. I do have some good progress to show you and I do have one empty, which is very exciting. I kind of wanted to have uploaded this sooner. I'm a little bit behind because by the time I'm uploading this, I think there's going to be only about 2.5 weeks left in this project, but that is okay. We'll see how much progress I can make. If you are interested, I do have an entire Project Pan playlist and I'm also doing a Pan That Palette. I have a playlist for that as well. I'll link those in the description box. And if you are interested in my makeup look, I did film this was a tutorial at the end of my August favorites video, so I will link that as well in the description box and in the cards if you want to see that. And let's get started. One of the items in this project, I did just have a goal of usage, and that was this palette right here. This is the Pat McGrath Golden Opulence palette. And my goal was to use this 30 times, and I have done that. I have surpassed my goal. I think I've actually used this more than 30 times at this point. And I really love this palette. I got this over 50% off in her sale that she had at the beginning of July, and it is beautiful. I mean, it's actually quite neutral. You know, you do have some pinky shades, but you have a warm brown and then a dark brown and then this gold. So this is a really good palette that I can just use with other palettes for an everyday type look, or, you know, you can also kind of glam it up. I really have enjoyed this palette. I'm really happy that I got it. Plus, I got it at an amazing price. The quality is fantastic. So I have used this over 30 times, which I'm very happy about. And I have talked about this in other videos. I am trying to incorporate a lot more usage in my projects in the last few months, just because I really want to take the pressure off a little bit. Sometimes the pressure of hitting pan, it can be kind of a lot. And then I feel like I'm really only focusing on one eyeshadow in a palette to do so. Whereas this, I could use whichever eyeshadow I want or the whole palette, you know, and that would count as a use. And I'm just kind of having fun with my makeup. So I am obviously still trying to hit pan and finish items, but I have really enjoyed, you know, a little bit more low-key with things like counting usage. And I know that's something a lot of other people do, and I think it's really great, and it's just a good way to just make sure you're using your products. Well, speaking of usage, I hardly use this. Kind of sad. I think I may just take it out of the project because I don't think I'm going to use it much. And that is this liquid lipstick by Kylie. This is in the color Bare. This is one of her velvets. I do like this, but I think I've only used it twice since putting it in this project because I just have not worn a whole lot of lipstick. And when I have worn lip products, I usually use gloss. Today I'm wearing lip liner with gloss, and that's just kind of been the thing for me lately. And yes, I'm not really going a whole lot of places, but I do enjoy applying lip gloss at home. It's kind of moisturizing, you know, it kind of substitutes as a lip balm. Therefore, I have done that a lot, but lipsticks, I just haven't really used them. Kind of a bummer, but is what it is. I do have some good progress on other items though. This concealer, I gotta say, I was hoping to have more progress on. I mean, it was pretty much full and now it's down to here. This is the e.l.f. Hydrating Camo Concealer. And I've used this pretty much every day that I have worn face makeup. You know, the whole mask thing I have mentioned, that some days I just wear eyeshadow and I don't bother with face makeup, but some days I do still wear it. And every time I have used this concealer, but it's a lot of coverage, so I really don't need a lot. I was expecting to finish this by the finale for this project, which clearly is not going to happen now that I've seen this measly amount of progress, but I have been using it and I really do like it. This is one of my favorite concealers, but yeah, it's a lot of coverage, so I only put on a small amount, and I am wearing this today. As usual, I gotta say though, I think it has gotten a little bit light for me. I have been outside a lot, so I've gotten a hint of a tan. And so lately I've also mixed this in with my ColourPop concealer, which is a darker color. Therefore, I think that also has slowed the progress down because I'm using even less because I'm combining it with another concealer. So is what it is. I mean, I'm making progress, but yeah, there's no way this is gonna be finished by the finale. Now this product I'm still hoping to finish. And that is the Iconic London Illuminator. This is in the color Original. I got this in BoxyCharm, and here's the progress. That's where I was at the intro, and here I am now. This is over halfway used up, and I really do enjoy this product. I use this, I either mix it in with foundation or I put it underneath my foundation to highlight, and then I still put a powder highlight on top. But I really like this a lot, and I've really enjoyed it. I'm hoping I could finish it. I mean, based on the amount of progress I've made, I'm hopeful. I really am. I would love to have another empty in this project since obviously this is not going to be done and this is not going to be done either. Therefore, this highlighter is my only hope, but we shall see. I mean, but based on this usage, I think I could finish it, hopefully. But yes, I do enjoy this, and I'm also very happy that I'm getting use on BoxyCharm items. I've mentioned before, I don't have BoxyCharm anymore, but I did have it for 6 months, and I want to make sure I'm using those products and I'm not just letting them sit around collecting dust. Alrighty, and we do have an empty. I'm very happy about this. I finished the e.l.f. foundation. I scraped this all out. I have used this 4 years, not this same bottle, obviously. I've repurchased this so much. This may be my most repurchased foundation. I think I've gone through 7 or 8 bottles. They've had this out for a while, although I think at some point they changed the name of it to the satin finish and they did expand their shade range, which is great. This is a great satin foundation. It is one of my favorite foundations of all time. And yes, I want to repurchase this. I really do. But right now I have 5 other foundations. Therefore, I do not need to repurchase it currently, but it's also only $6, which is amazing. And luckily I usually can find my color at Target. I have 140 light ivory and this really does match me perfectly. I just really enjoy this foundation. The only thing I will say, and I've mentioned before, it's 0.68 fluid ounces for $6. So it's not like a full size 1 ounce, but it's still pretty cheap in my opinion. And the quality is great, but I am happy I did finish a foundation because I think 6 foundations may be a bit too much. I think 4 would be a better number for me, but I do like to have a little bit of variety. I do like to have something lighter coverage and something more heavy coverage. This is kind of like the perfect in-between medium coverage. It is great, but I am happy I'm using up foundations. That is it for this project pan update. I'm happy about the empty. I do wish I had a little more progress, you know, on the concealer, and I kind of had wish I'd use the lipstick, but it is what it is. I'm hoping I can finish that liquid highlighter though. That would be absolutely amazing. And like I said, if you want to see this makeup look, I will link that in the description box and also my project pan playlist, my pan that palette playlist. That is it. Thank you so much for watching.